Going on, everyone. Welcome, Rabbit here. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to mine Zealous to the Cryptex mining pool for 0% pool fee. So as we can see, Cryptex currently has a prop and a solo pool, both at 0% for the remainder of the entire month. So that means everything you mine is fee free on Zealous. I'm sure most of you are aware by now, but if not, Zealous is one of the top profitable coins for your GPU mining rigs currently. And over here for payout options, Cryptex does have a minimum payout of 0.1 Zell, a max payout of 10,000. You can set your own threshold depending on the hash rate that you have, but keep in mind you cannot go lower than 0.1. There's currently 916 miners online and 2,170 workers. Now, to begin mining this coin, you're going to need a wallet. So you're going to want a wallet here, and Cryptex Pool does recommend the Node wallet. That is the recommended wallet you should use for the CLI, but a lot of people don't want to deal with a Node and the CLI and so on. So there is a GUI wallet beta currently available. It does work just fine. I have used it in the past, and that's this guy right here. Once you kind of sign up, get everything done, you get a seed phrase by simply going into your settings here and view seed. Put in your password that you did set when you set this up, and everything will work just fine. And here you can see your seed phrase. Write this phrase down. This is how you're going to restore your wallet later on in the future if your computer crashes, or maybe you get a new hard drive. Any way you need to restore your wallet, this seed phrase will do it for you. So make sure you do save that. I don't have anything in this wallet, as you can see here. So you can try hacking it all you want. You're not going to get anything. But there is a few steps you need to do in order to get this to run, depending what you already have installed. Now, depending what all you got running on your PC, you may already have Microsoft Visual C++ working already, so you don't need to download this. If your wallet is not working for you, then you are going to have to download the x86 version as well as the x64 version. Links to everything will be in the description. Without these, your wallet's going to say it's missing DLL files and all sorts of crazy stuff. But if it just loads up, then you already got these and you're good to go. But I just want to point out, if you're having issues with your wallet loading, you are going to have to install those two files. Next up, you're gonna need a miner, and no one does it better than Mr. Regal Miner. 1.17.4 is the current latest version, which has yet some more hash rate boost. So here we go. We're going to be setting up the latest Regal Miner. This is for NVIDIA GPUs only. Sadly, it seems like AMD is losing support in all kind of coins, and you know, miners aren't updating for it, and AMD is not even making a next new gen to compete with the 5090. I feel AMD GPUs are just dying out in the terms of crypto mining. Regardless, we're going to rock Regal Miner here, and this is for NVIDIA GPUs. So once you do download Regal Miner, you know, that awesome NVIDIA miner, you're going to come into a bunch of bat files like this. You may get a notification from Windows saying it's a virus. Just allow it and everything will be just fine. It says that for most crypto miners. So you're going to come down to XEL here, which is Zealous. We're going to edit this file, and you can see right here that it has mined to Viper, K1, Cryptex, or solo mine to your own node. Now, this is already the default stratum for Cryptex. As we can see, zell.cryptex.network port 7777. If we come into the website, we can see zell.cryptex.network port 7777. So everything is already there, set up nice and easy. So what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to add two colons right here, because the ones without the colon, that's the line it's going to run. So it's going to default to Viper here, and then it's not even going to have your wallet address or anything there, and you're going to get errors and wondering what's going on. So you just add those colons in there. Next, we're going to come down and we're going to remove the colons in front of Cryptex. Now we're going to put our wallet address right here. So we're just going to remove this, and by the dash U, I'm simply going to paste in my wallet address, and this is what I'm going to mine to and receive my coins in my wallet. Now, I still don't know if the actual worker name is fixed or not yet, so I'm going to put my worker name behind my wallet address as well as in the worker spot here. So I'm going to go with this and then Rabid WS, so you can see my wallet address followed by a period, my worker name, and then I'm going to put my worker name right here as well, Rabid WS. Now, it should only work when it's here. Early versions, when Zealous first came out, it was not working, so that's why I put it here. Now it's just a habit. I put it in both places every time, and it does turn up. So at that point, you're going to file, save this. Your bat file is now saved, and it will run. So now we're going to need some overclock settings, and I like to use the LOL Miner GUI for setting my overclocks. I'm just going to bring up Afterburner here just to kind of show you what happens. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to pick the GPU that I'm going to be using. This is the onboard 7950X graphics card. I'm not going to be using onboard graphics here. We're using my 4090. So I'm going to click the lock core, click the offset, and I'm setting the memory offset. So I'm actually going to run 1000 on the memory offset. I'm going to run the core offset. This is like dropping your voltage. So right now you can see I'm running 2600 core. So it's going to lock the core and it's going to lock the power limit at that 2600 core. Now the core offset here, as I move a number up, it's actually going to drop the voltage, which is like undervolting your GPU while trying to maintain this. If you go too high here, you're going to run into instability options. So that's kind of what this means in a nutshell. Play around with the numbers, see what works for you. Hook up to a watt meter, do some testing. At that point, I'm going to hit the apply OCs. We're going to hit OK. Minimize this. You can see now I'm at 2610. Now this is going to jump around 5001, 810, whatever. I'm kind of on a beta version here, so it doesn't really know what it's doing, but we can see our core did lock here. Once I start mining, it will be correct and start showing the right megahertz for my memory. So now that we got our bat file set up, we got our overclock set up, I'm now just going to simply double click on the bat file we made. Everything should begin mining to the Cryptex mining pool. So I'm just going to close this out here. And now we can see we are beginning to get some hash rates on the RTX 4090. So next you're going to want to come into the pool and put your mining address right here and then search for it. This will then tell you how many coins you've been mining and what your hash rate and everything is. It looks like we already have one worker detected. I do have to wait a little bit. Actually, I guess I don't have to wait any longer at all. My Rabbit workstation is here. We still don't have hash rate, but I pretty much just turned it on, so it's going to take a few minutes here. So we are seeing we are detected here. After a matter of time, you will start getting average hash rates. You'll start to see unconfirmed balances as the pool's finding blocks, and your balance in coins will start going up. And one day in the bull run, hopefully we're all rich. All right, so now that Windows is complete, let's check out HiveOS. So the first thing I am going to do is come into my rig that does have my GPUs in it, and I see there's an update. So you are going to want to update this to make sure you are running the latest RegalMiner 1.17.4. So simply click here, click here. Sometimes it doesn't reboot, so I recommend manually rebooting it when it's done, just to make sure, but sometimes it does. But I always like to do that extra feature of a manual reboot after the update. So we're just gonna upgrade this right now. While it's doing its thing, we're gonna come back into our rigs here, go to our wallets, and we're gonna have to set up our wallet. So once we're in here, we're gonna click on Add Wallet, go to Coin and Ticker here, and I'm just gonna put XEL. As we can see now, Exelis is actually added in here by default. So I need to set this up because I'm just using the one I created before it was actually here. So I'm going to click on that. I'm going to paste my wallet address in like so. And I'm going to name this GUI/node because they're both running off the same seed phrase. So they both talk to each other. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm going to create that wallet. All good. Now I'm going to come back into my workers here just to see if it updated yet. Hit that refresh. Bam, it looks like it is complete now. So I don't think it actually rebooted. It should have took a little longer. So now I'm just going to go to Power Actions and hit the reboot button. While we're waiting for that, we can set up our flight sheet. So I'm going to click on my flight sheet here. Once it loads up here, now I'm going to select Zealous. So XEL, we can see right there, we just made it. The wallet I just made is named right there. We're going to select our pool. As Cryptex is here by default, so that makes things super easy. So their global server, exact same one we use in Windows. We're going to click on that, hit the apply button, select miner. I'm going to hit RegalMiner like so, and I'm going to name this Exelis GPU, and then I'm going to go Cryptex. That way I know exactly where this pool is going, and then we're going to set up our miner config. So here we can see Exelis hash is already here. Wallet is already here. Now I do want to add my worker name just like I did in Windows there. So wallet.workername and also the worker name within the worker field. And now you can see the pool URL. It'll pull everything defaulted in the Hive. And now we're going to set some overclock settings. So I'm going to copy my overclock settings I was using. So I'm just going to paste that in here. But you can see the commands used to set your overclock settings. So here is your --lock-c clock. That is locking your core clock. I actually want to move this down from 1500 to probably around 1475. This is your C clock. So this is your clock offset, which we kind of talked about earlier. This is like undervolting your actual clocks on your GPU there. And then we're going to be locking my memory to 8001. Now, it is better, I think, for Zealous to do an offset where you would add an extra 1000 in Windows, 2000 in Hive OS, depending on the NVIDIA GPU you do have. But you should do an offset. It does work a bit better because you'll be running around 11 or 12,000 megahertz. So locking it at 8001 is a bit lower. But at the same time, I have some A2000 stuff in here, and they don't allow the memory to go that high. Now, obviously, I can set my clocks per GPU as well, which is recommended. I just run everything because I'm lazy. But here you can see if I wanted to set GPU 0 at 8001, this is what I would do. And then say for the next one, say I wanted 5001, that'd be GPU 1. And then we say I want 5001 on GPU 3, and then 8001 on GPU 4. It goes 0, 1, 2, 3, even though it's your four GPUs here, 1, 2, 3, 4. In Linux and Hive and most miners, it's numbered as 0 being your first one. So 0, 1, 2, 3. And this is how you do it. Now, if you only have one thing set like this, then it's going to apply the same overclock settings to every GPU you have in the rig. So I'm just going to apply those settings right here and create that flight sheet. Now I'm going to scroll back up and go to my workers and kind of explain the worker numbers to you, just how I kind of was mentioning here. So we can see GPU 0 is right here, the 3060. GPU 1 is an A2000. GPU 2 is A2000. GPU 3 is A2000. GPU 4 is a 3060. So as you put that comma and overclock settings in, it'll do it for each individual GPU. But because I just ran one, it's going to do the same overclocks for every single one. So now that that's all set, we're going to run this flight sheet and begin mining Zealous. So we're going to scroll down here. This is the flight sheet we just made, and I'm going to hit the rocket ship, and it should start connecting to the pool within a couple minutes here. So we can see we're getting some hash rate here for the past 4.5 minutes. We're gonna jump into the pool, and we can see two workers are now detected. Scrolling down, we're getting valid shares, nothing stale, nothing invalid. That's everything we would like to see. It tells you that you are on the latest regional miner, and everything's all good. Now, if you're looking to change your settings here, like settings, you click on this. This is where you put in your IP address, and then you just change your default to how much you want to get paid out in, 0.1 upwards to 10,000. Obviously, you need a pretty big farm if you want to get daily payouts of 10,000 Zealous. Not happening for me. But regardless, this is where you will change your payouts on how much you want to get paid per day, per week, whatever, in the settings tab there. But everything is looking like it's working very, very well. And remember, guys, till the end of the month, this is 0% pool fees. So collect as much Zealous as you can before it's too late. Thank you for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Rabbit out.